Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. We're back. Blessing the Lord, giving him praise, and giving him thanks. Hallelujah. He that the Son is set free is free indeed. No more chain, no, of slavery. The truth has triumphed with liberty. He that the Son is set free is free indeed. Yeah. I'm talking about my Savior. I'm talking about my Lord, yeah. I'm not bound to sin no more. I open up my heart and let Jesus in, yeah. And his word is moving in me with so much freedom, yeah. He that the Son has set free, yeah. I remember standing on the auction block of sin. Satan controlled me, he had the highest bid. And one day on a ship was transferred, one day at Calvary. Jesus whispered, son, I bought you so that I could set you free. He that the Son has set free, it's free indeed. No more chain, no, of slavery. You see, the truth has triumphed with liberty. He that the Son is set free, is free indeed. Listen, y'all. Now, I belong to Jesus. I'm a child of the King. I traded filthy garments for a robe of royalty. Listen, now the chains that used to bind me, they're laying at my feet. You see, the devil hasn't made a lock that my Lord doesn't hold the key. No, he let the Son set free, yeah. It's free indeed. Listen, y'all, I'm not bound to sin no more. Let me tell you, I opened up my heart and let Jesus in, yeah. And his word is moving in me with so much freedom, yes. He that the Son is set free. I got to tell you one more time, y'all. I'm talking about my Savior. I'm talking about my Lord, yeah. Talking about Yahshua the King. Glory, glory, glory to his holy name, cause his word is moving in me. So much freedom, yes. He that the Son is set free. Free, yes he is, yes he is, yes he is. Now I tell you, you can be free today. Yes, you can be free, y'all. All you gotta do is open up your heart, let my Savior in. He will move in you. Yes, he will. Yes, he will. With so much freedom, yes. He that the Son has set free. Let me tell you one more time. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I'm talking about our Savior. I'm talking about our Lord, yeah. They call him the King of Kings. Call him the Lord of Lords. Yes, he is. Holy One of Israel. Yeah. He's moving with so much freedom. Yeah. He that the Son is set free. I'm talking to you one more time. You can hear me now. You ought to bend your heart right now. Give it to him and let him clean you up. My God has set you free. Yeah. Free indeed. Hallelujah. Bless his name. Bless his name. He is worthy to be praised. Hallelujah. God is moving today with so much freedom. We welcome you. We welcome you once, twice. We welcome you three times. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost. We're glad that you're here with us today. And we want you to know you are free. You are free to worship him. in spirit and in truth. For our God is a spirit. The Bible declares that the hour will come, and now is, today, that the true worshipers, the ones that have been born again, set free by the word of Jesus Christ, the true worshipers shall worship the Father in spirit and in truth. Let your worship be real. Why? For the Father seeketh such to worship him. How? In spirit and truth. Why? For God is a spirit, and they that worship him must. You don't have a choice. Must worship him in spirit and in truth. Welcome again to ever-increasing Kingdom of God ministry. I am Apostle Darnell Wilson, pastor of ever-increasing Kingdom of God ministry international. And we welcome you here. We welcome you to break the bread of life today with us as we go to the book of Isaiah in chapter 58. We wrapped up. Chapter 59. We wrapped up 58 last week. I believe we did. And now we are getting ready to operate in 58. My bad. 58. Praise the Lord. And what we're looking at, blessings follow obedience to God. Can I say that again? In Isaiah chapter 58, the whole focuses on blessings follow obedience to God. You obey, blessings gonna flow. You obey, you can say, as we say, I'm blessed in the city, I'm blessed in the field, I'm blessed becoming and I'm blessed going. Hallelujah. We can claim that when we are in the word of Christ. Amen. Hallelujah. Let me readjust my music just a little bit. God is in the blessing business, but we have to walk in obedience to him. And today we just want to enlighten some, and then we want to encourage others. Amen? Amen. So we're going to look at the book of Isaiah. Here you go, wife. Take the mic, because you're going to be talking today. Can you be heard?
Hallelujah. Glory to God.
Amen. Amen. Yeah, you're now. Praise the Lord. Oh, yeah. For the old that they can't see it, this is my good thing. Prophetess Doris Wilson. And she's right. Been by my side for many a years. And I want to thank all y'all first before we move on for the birthday wishes you gave me, as God has blessed me to become 70 years old. And I'm thankful that he kept me this long. Amen. And I truly believe I got another 70 to go with somebody.
Hallelujah.
Because I asked for what I want. I don't know about y'all, but I asked for long life. I asked to be in my right mind and able to still be able to walk and get around, especially when I hit that 90 mark. And I'm going to be there. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. God bless you all. So we're going to move on now, and we're going to look at blessings follow obedience to God. Chapter 58 and verse 1, read.
Hallelujah. Isaiah 58 verse 1. Cry aloud,
hallelujah.
Spare not.
Yes.
Lift up your voice like a trumpet, and show my people their transgression, and the house of Jacob their sin.
Hallelujah. Stop right there. See, let me tell you something. We told you last week what that cry aloud is. That's proclaim the good news. And you got to tell it. You got to tell it wherever you go. You can tell it in the store. You can tell it on the floor, if that's where you're laying at. You can tell it on top of the house. But you got to shout out the good word of the Lord God Almighty, Yahweh Yahshua, and through his son, Yahshua, the word of Yahweh. You got to tell it. And he says, cry aloud. And then he said, what? Spare not. You don't worry about what somebody got to say about you. Don't spare the word of God. It's just like when he tells you in the word in the book about spare the rod, you'll spoil the child. You don't spare the rod of God, the word of God, or your child will be spoiled. because they don't have no discipline. Help me, Holy Ghost. Thank you right now. And then he said, lift up your voice like a trumpet. Now, if any of y'all done heard the trumpet play, baby, it is nice and loud. Hallelujah. Even the shofar, what they blow, it's a loud sound. That's where the trumpet get the melody from, the shofar. So that's a loud noise which caused the congregation to come near and hear what thus says the Lord. He said, and show my people. Show who? Show my people. He's talking about his people, Israel. He said, show my people their transgressions and the house of Jacob their sins. Let me tell you something, baby. That's coming all 12 tribes. He said, show his people the errors of their way, how they trespassing against my word, and then show them, hallelujah, their sins. Point it out. What you're doing, it's not called for anymore. You say, well, wait a minute, hold on. What you mean not called for anymore? But see, I got some folks out there watching me right now, and they're going to have a debate, but I'm not debating with nobody. I'm telling you what thus says the Lord. You are transgressing against God when you refuse to accept his son, Yahshua the Christ. Hear what I'm saying? Now I got to move on. Read on, my sister.
Hallelujah. Yet they seek me daily and delight to know my ways.
Come on.
As a nation that did righteousness and forsook not the ordinance of their God, they asked me the ordinances of justice. They take delight in approaching to God.
Listen what he say. They seek me daily and delight to know my ways as a nation that did righteousness. You know, you're perpetrating. You're a nation that is not obeying God's, or you're transgressing against God, and you're walking in your own sinful ways. But God says these words, you take delight. You seek him daily, and you take the light to know my ways as a nation that did righteousness, perpetrating like you're doing what's right before God, hello, and forsook not the ordinance of their God. They ask of me the ordinance of justice. They take the light in approaching me. Oh, they feel good about what they're doing. They feel good about they crying out to God. They crying out to Yahweh. They ain't never putting them crying out to Yahweh in the name of Yahshua, Jesus the Christ. But they crying out to Yahweh. Listen to what he said. Listen to what he said. And they take the light in approaching God. Go ahead, verse 3.
Wherefore have we fasted?
They say.
Say they. And you see it not?
You don't see me?
Wherefore have we afflicted our soul?
And
you taketh no knowledge?
You don't even see how we going through all kind of persecutions in our souls. How our soul is like it's being torn apart. And yet and still, you don't take knowledge that that's what's going on. We're doing this for you. Read on.
And you take no knowledge of? Behold, in the day of your fast, you find pleasure and exalt all your labor.
And exact
all your labor.
Listen, let me say, behold, in the day of your fast, the ones you proclaim, not the one God has told you to proclaim. You're not fasting like God told you to fast. Mm. You call them to fast so we can increase the finances in the church. Hello, somebody. Help me, Lord. Lead my tongue, great Jehovah. Hallelujah. Lead my tongue, Holy Spirit.
Speak as an ordinance.
Listen. He say, you take, you fast and find pleasure, and you lack, and you exact all your labors. Man, I'm doing this for the Lord. God told me to tell you we need to increase our finances. We're going to call forth a day of fasting. And we're going to fast for the outreach ministry. Hello, somebody. Stop it. God didn't tell you to fast for that type of stuff. If that's a fast, that's your solemn fast. Why you want to make the church do it all? Hello. Some people don't want to fast for outreach ministry. They just want to go out there and minister and use the word of God. Now, I ain't putting nobody down. Please do not take this as I'm knocking your outreach ministry down, because I'm not. But we got to be careful what we fast for. And we're going to read what we fast for shortly. He says this, and you take delight in approaching God. Did we read 3 yet?
Yes.
Wherefore you have fasted, you say, and thou sayest not, seest not. Wherefore have you afflicted your souls, and thou takest no knowledge? Behold, in the day of your fast, you find pleasure. And exact all your labors. You talk about what you did for the Lord. Hello. Go ahead on, my sister.
Verse 4. Behold, you fast for strife and debate. And to smite with the fist of wickedness.
Oh, hallelujah.
You shall not fast as you do this day to make your voice to be heard on high.
Hallelujah. Look at it. It's all about self, y'all. It's all about me, myself, and I. He said, behold, you fast for strife and debate. I've had some folks to ask me to confront some people. And I said, no, because I'm not going to have no debate about what thus says the Lord. I'm not going to even argue about what the word of God says. If you can't receive what the word of God says, face value from the book, then you can't receive what I got to say, because you're not reading what I'm reading. Well, listen to what he said. He said, behold, you fast for strife and debate. Strife. Mm. Oh, my God.
Yes, just to argue about.
Just to argue about something that you believe that somebody told you is the right thing, but you didn't go and search these scriptures for yourself. Help me, Holy Ghost. He said, and to smite with the fist of wickedness. Oh my God, not the fist of righteousness, but the fist of wickedness. You shall not fast as you do this day to make your voice to be heard on high. Come on now. When he told us to cry out loud, he didn't tell us to fast to cry out loud. He said, proclaim the good news. You ain't got to fast to proclaim the righteousness of God, who is Christ Yeshua, the Holy One of Israel. I got to move on now. Read.
Hallelujah.
Verse 5.
Is it such a fast that I have chosen?
Hold up. Did I tell you to do that? Thus says the Lord. Did I tell you to do that? Move on.
A day for a man to afflict his soul.
Oh, man, just making your soul feel. Oh, man, you're just pulling your soul down. But you think you're doing it for the Lord. You just add stuff to your soul that is tearing up your relationship with the Father. Read on.
Is it to bow down his head as a bulrush and to spread sackcloth and ashes under him?
Oh, my God, my God, my God. He says, is it such a fast I have chosen? Did I chose that for you? A day for a man afflicted soul? Did I do that? Is it to bow down his head like a bulrush and to spread sackcloth and ashes under him? Will I call this, will you call this a fast and an acceptable day to the Lord? Read on.
Is not this the fast that I have chosen? To loose the bands of wickedness.
Come on now.
To undo the heavy burden.
Yes.
And to let the oppressed go free.
And?
That you shall break every yoke.
Now, he asking a question. See, he asking you now, and he's trying to get you to answer this. He say, is not this the fast I have chosen? Did I not choose this fast? What fast, Apostle? This fast right here. Is not this the fast that I have chosen? The fast to loose the bands of wickedness? The fast to undo heavy burdens? Instead of you putting burdens on somebody, taking burdens off of them, getting them to try to obey Moses' law, but to get them to realize that Christ Jesus, Christ Yeshua, our Lord and Savior, fulfilled the law. I'm moving on. Listen what he said. Glory to God. This is so good. This is so good. To undo the heavy burdens. Hallelujah. And to let the oppressed go free. And that you break every yoke. This is what I have called for the men and women of the body of Christ, of the kingdom of God. This is what I have called you to do. I've called you not to put people in bondage, but to set the captive free. Loose the bonds of wickedness. Give them the truth, because the truth shall make you free. Are y'all listening to me right now? I'm telling you now, this ain't no game, baby. This is for real. This is for real. And this is what we're supposed to be doing. Apostles, prophets, evangelists, pastors, teachers, ministers, bishops, deacons. We all supposed to be doing the same work. The work that God called us to do. We're not supposed to be putting people in bondage, causing them to stray. Hallelujah. Verse 7.
Is it not to deal your bread to the hungry?
Uh-huh.
And that you bring the poor that are cast out to your house?
Uh-huh.
When you see it, the naked?
Yes.
That you cover him?
Uh-huh.
And that you hide not yourself from thine own flesh?
Ooh, this is good here now. This is what he said. I want you to hear this real good. He said, is it not to deal thy bread to the hungry? Oh, you talking about my money, Pastor? Apostle? No, I'm not talking about your money. I'm talking about the word of God. The bread of life. The same bread that he rained down from heaven was called manna, which was Christ Yeshua. His body, his bread came down. And then he gave him meat. He gave him meat to eat. His body to eat. Hello. We're supposed to be dealing this bread to the people, so that they can eat Christ's word. They can eat his ordinances. They can eat his standards. And apply them to their life, so that they will not sin against him. Glory to hallelujah. I got to move on. I got to read some more now. This is what he says. He says, and that you bring the poor that are cast out into thine house. Now, that's where we're talking about street ministry now. That's where we're getting out there and telling them the truth. Telling them about the gospel of Christ. Telling them about what happened to him. And then when we get them in the house, then we got to start feeding them some meat, baby. You give them the milk, then you start getting them the meat of the word. Amen. So that their lives will grow thereby. Moving right along, he says, when thou seest the naked, you should cover him, and that you hide not yourself from your own flesh. See, you got some stuff going on in you, and you trying to cover yours up. God called that presumptuous sin. That's the sin nobody knows about but you and God. But you presuming that everything is all right with you and the Father. But it's not, because you're hiding that sin from the people and think you're hiding it from God, because you keep on perpetrating and doing it, but you're out of order, baby. Wake up, smell them roses while they smell good, because they'll fade and die, and you can't smell nothing. I'm here to tell you, God is ministering to his body today. God is trying to bring blessings in your life if you will come under obedience. Read on, my sister.
Verse 8. Then shall your light break forth as the morning.
Uh-huh.
And thy health shall spring forth speedily.
Rest, yes.
And your righteousness shall go before you. The glory of the Lord shall be your reward.
Read it again. That last word, read it again.
Reward.
That's right. You said reward. But it's your reward. He's going to reward you again. But you got to do this. What we just read up in verse 6 and verse 7, that has to be your transformation crusade in your life. You must have a transformation crusade going on in your life every day. You can't just do it one day, baby, because it ain't going to get done in one day. You sin to God for many a days. You sin against God. You sin against His Son. You sin against His Word. You got to get it right before you get left. He said, and then, he said this. Listen, I'm going to read it again. He said, then shall thy light break forth as the morning. Baby, the sun is rising up every morning, making it shine bright. Make darkness go away. Hello, somebody. Listen, we say, and thine health shall spring forth speedily. Because you're going to be in good health. He said, I would that you prosper and be in good health, even as your soul prosper. See, you got to get your soul right. And you got to get healthy in your soul. Glory to God. Oh, somebody didn't hear me then. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. And it shall spring forth speedily. And thy righteousness shall go before you. The glory of the Lord shall be your reward. Where did we find the glory of the Lord? God come forth with grace and mercy, and the glory of the Lord begin to grow inside of you. And Dr. Fred Hammond, he had the idea when he made glory to glory to glory to glory to God. So when you do enter in His kingdom and He come and see you, you're going to give back all the glory He gave you. You're going to present it back to Him. Oh, bless the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. So you got to surrender, baby. And you can't surrender a little bit. You got to surrender all. Let me read on. And he says, the glory of the Lord shall be thy reward. He going to redo it again. You know how he said replenish? He told him to replenish the earth. He going to reward you. Because at one time you were walking in it. You had your reward going forward in righteousness. Hallelujah. Mm. Somebody bewitched you and got you to stop believing in Christ Yeshua. Mm. And you was there. And you switched out. Mm. Jesus. God is calling for you, baby, to come back home. Mm. Yes. And withhold nothing from Him.
Yes.
Nothing. Withhold nothing from Him. Hallelujah. Give it up. Turn it loose. Move it right along.
Verse 9. Then shall you call.
Uh-huh.
And the Lord shall answer.
Hello.
You shall cry, and He shall say.
What He say?
Here I am.
Oh, glory to God.
If you take away from the midst of you the yoke, the putting forth of the finger, and speaking vanity.
Daddy wants you to come back, baby. Daddy is speaking to you. Come home. Come home where you belong. Apostle is crying out to you right now. Come home, baby. Those who are looking at me right now, God is speaking to you. Let Him touch your heart.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Be you transformed by the renewing of your mind. And be ye not transformed, be ye not conformed to this world, the world's philosophy, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind. Let me move on.
Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
Verse 10.
No. Let me play with it a little bit more, baby. And he says this, and Yahweh, who did I say?
Yahweh.
Yahovia, if you want to use that name. Yahovia shall answer. See, God ain't going to be slow to answer you when you surrender all to Him. He said, and Yahovia shall answer. Thou shalt cry, and He shall say, here I am, son. Here I am, daughter. Here I am, my children. I'm right here. Talk to me. Hallelujah. I love it. I love it. I love it. Oh, He's so good. Yes, He is. If you, listen to, here's the requirements. Here's the condition. If thou take away from the midst of thee the yoke, that yoke of bondage, and you're spreading that yoke to the people that God has blessed you with, You got to remove that yoke of bondage. Listen to what he said. Hallelujah. Take away from the midst of you. You got it all in the midst of you. The yoke of bondage. Hello. Your yoke. The putting forth of the finger. That's why I'm telling you, I ain't trying to put you down, baby. I'm trying to build you up. I may point my finger. But listen, as I'm building you up, there's four fingers pointing back toward me. Can y'all see them? There's my thumb. There's three fingers down and only one pointing at you, baby. He say, and the pointing of the finger. Oh, your glory to God. I got to read on now. I got to read on now. Help me, Holy Ghost. I'm in what verse?
The latter part of nine.
Nine. And putting forth the finger and speaking vanity. Now, there's three things God is talking about here right now. And let me share them with you right quick. The putting forth of the finger. These words speak of slavery. That's number one, the yoke. That's slavery. The yoke was on our people's neck for 400 years. The yoke of slavery was all over them. And let me tell you something else. It was on their necks for 400 years before God even spoke to the prophet John. The yoke of bondage was on Israel's neck. But when he told John to proclaim the good news about Yahshua, the one he said, I'm not even worthy to tie his shoes up. Glory to God. Are you listening at me out there? Hallelujah. So he said, first of all, you got to stop putting yokes on people. And then, because that's slavery. You're putting them in slavery. And then you got to try quit trying to bribe them and trying to get them to do this for that. And I'll do this for you. You got to quit trying to bribe the people of God. And then you got to stop lying to them. That's what all that's talking about. I'm going to call them out to you so you hear them. Hallelujah. He said, thou should take away the yoke from the midst of thee, the yoke, slavery, bondage, the putting forth of the finger, trying to bribe them. Hallelujah. With the finger, this, you do this, I'm going to do this for you. You keep doing what you're doing, and I'll bless you myself. God going to give me something to bless you with. Stop it. And then he says, finally, amen, speaking emptiness. In other words, lying to the people. Stop it. Move on, my sister.
Verse 10. And if thou draw out your soul to the hungry and satisfy the afflicted soul,
hallelujah,
then shall your light rise in obscurity and your darkness be as the noonday.
Hallelujah. Let me reach over here and get some notes I wrote down. That word obscurity. Listen what he says and read it again, my sister.
And if you draw out thy soul to the hungry.
Now listen. You got to pour out your soul to the hungry. You got to get the word of God in it and pour out your soul to those people that are hungry for the word of God. Yes. You got to give them the truth, yes, baby. That's why he told you to stop lying up there in the other verse.
Yes.
And you got to grab the truth now and start feeding the people, yes, with the truth, yes, with the word, yes, of the Lord.
Yes.
Move on.
And satisfy the afflicted soul.
Uh-huh.
Then shall thy light arise in obscurity.
Now, listen. You got to satisfy the afflicted soul.
Yes.
That,
yes,
soul, yes, that is going through something.
Yes.
And you got the word of God to bring healing,
yes,
to bring deliverance. Yes. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. To set the captive free.
Yes, yes.
Mm.
The souls are being afflicted.
Hallelujah. Those, yes, souls, yes, that are being, yes, afflicted. Come on. I'm going to read, yes, on a little bit more. Listen to what he says. Then shall your light rise in obscurity. Now, the word obscurity means the state of being unknown, inconspicuously, or unimportant. When you are not conforming to the word of God, what you're going to speak out your mouth is going to be unimportant, baby. You're going to start speaking what thus says the Lord. Listen to what he says. Unknown. Hallelujah. The quality of being difficult to understand. You won't be having a word that is hard to understand. When you return to him and begin to speak with, thus says the Lord. Read on.
And thy darkness be as the noonday.
See, the more you speak the word, the more the light comes. Mm. Now, what does it look like outside at noonday? That's the brightest day, brightest time that the sun shines and it's beaming down on your head. And it's very bright at noonday. Hello, somebody. God say that's how it's going to be when you come back to him, when you obey his word. Your hallelujah. Listen what he said. Read it again, my sister.
And thy darkness be as the noonday.
The light, what does light do? Drive away darkness. The more you put the light in you, the more you put the word of God in you, darkness got to flee. Amen. It can't stay there. Hello, somebody. Move on, my sister.
Verse 11. And the Lord shall guide you continually and satisfy your soul in drought.
Hello.
And make fat your bones.
Uh-huh.
And you shall be like a watered garden.
Hello.
And like a spring of water.
Yes.
Whose waters fail not.
You ought to be shouting right now when you heard the word of God read. This is what God is trying to do for his people that will follow his word and his commandments and follow the new covenant that he has laid out for us, which is the New Testament, not the Old Testament. That's why it's called a new covenant, a New Testament, because Christ came along and established a New Testament for the people of God to follow, because you could not follow the Old Testament. So listen what he says. And the Lord shall guide thee continually if you give it up and turn it loose. He will not forsake thee. He'll never leave ye. Lo, he will be with you even until the end. He said, the Lord shall guide thee continually and satisfy your souls in the dry season. He'll rain down on you when you seem like you ain't got nothing to say. God's Holy Spirit will come in and he will rain down in your spirit, and he'll lead you to a word, the word of God, not a word, to the word of God that will spring forth as a well springing out of your belly shall flow living waters. God of us. Thus says the Lord, not apostle. Thus says the Lord. He says, and to satisfy you and make fat your bones, and thou shalt be like a watered garden. Baby, when you water that garden, guess what happened? Them vegetables, they begin to spring up and grow, and boy, there's food for the harvest. You ain't heard what I just said. He'll make you be like a watered garden. Hello, baby. You got food to feed the people with. Move right on, he says, and he says also, hallelujah, and like a spring of water, the word of God, a spring bubbles up all the time. It's continually pushing up clean water. We got a place called Zephyr Hill, and in Zephyr Hill, that's spring water. They bottles it up and they sell it. That's spring water. And also, we have a place called Lithia Spring. Oh, come on with it now. You ain't heard what I said. And then they got one called Sulphur Spring. Hallelujah. And let me tell you something. These springs been around before I was born. Before my dad and mama was born. These springs been here forever. There's other springs all over Florida. And they don't do nothing but Zeus good drinking water. I'm finna move on now. Listen what he says. He says, and hallelujah, and like a spring of water whose waters fail not. See, when you speak of the word of God, it won't fail. It can't fail. Hallelujah. I felt that all in my bones. It can't fail you, baby. You cannot fail. When you speaking what thus says the Lord, please hear me, my fellow yokemen. Please hear me, brothers and sisters that are locked in as servants of the Most High God. Please hear what thus says the Lord today. He's not playing. And I ain't playing either. You gotta hear it, baby. Read on, my sister.
Verse 12. And they that shall be of thee shall build the old waste places. You shall raise up the foundation of many generations. And you shall be called the repairer of the breach. the restorer of paths to dwell in.
Hallelujah. Now, whoa, Lord have mercy. You're going to even get a good name. You're going to get a whole new name. Listen what he says. Hallelujah, hallelujah. He says, and they who? They shall be of the you. Because you're going to spread the word of God. And then you're going to be teaching the word of God. And they're going to be just like you. Speaking the truth. Sharing this good news to somebody else that may be in their family that are bound up and trying to do something God didn't call them to do. They may be trying to obey Moses' law and they're going to be set free. I got some people that I love so much and they steady trying to get me to submit to Moses' law, but I can't. I got a Lord and Savior. I got a Messiah who was anointed to bring in the change, because his Father anointed him to bring change to the people's life. And I got to obey the Father Yahweh, who sent his Son to establish the kingdom of God down here on earth. I got to follow him. I got to move on now. He says, and oh, hallelujah. He says, and they shall be of thee, and shall build the old waste places, where it's been nothing now. At one time, it had some feel in it. But now it's wasted. And now you're going to fill it up with the word of God. There's some folks out there need to be filled up with the word of God. The wasted people. The enemy that came in and stole what God had put in their life. And they started following some traditions and rudiments of man. And they lost it. And it became like a desert. A wasted place. Thou shalt raise up the nations of... the foundation. Thou shalt raise up the foundations of... What now? Read it again. Many generations. He ain't talking about just the generations of Israel. He talking about many generations that come to know the Lord Jesus Christ. The seed of Abraham shall be many nations, and they got to be taught the word of God. He told Abraham, you shall be a father of many nations. Many generations is going to receive the teaching if you just do it.
Amen.
Glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. And thou shalt be called, what's your name? What's your name when he want to give you? My brothers and sisters, he want to call you this because you're doing this type of work. He's saying, and your name shall be called what? Help me say it, my sister. The repair of the breach. You're going to restore that gap that had been set between you and the Father. The gap will be restored through Yahshua the Christ. Are y'all hearing me? You hear me? I know you hear me. But do you hear me? What about you? You will be called the repair of the breach. That's my job. And God wants many more people that he's called to be in the fivefold ministry to be repairs of the breach. Take that gap from between God and his people. See, let me tell you something. I'm not picking on you. I'm just trying to tell you the truth. As long as you keep trying to teach Moses' law and trying to keep people to keep those festivals back in the Old Testament, hello, you are causing these people to get further gapped away from God when God told you that he that the Son is set free is free indeed. That's why I sung that song this morning. This afternoon. Because he that the Son is set free indeed. He that the Son set free. And there's no more chains of slavery. Why? For the truth has triumphed with liberty.
Yes.
Grab hold to the truth. Here we go. I'm going to that new covenant. And you shall know the truth. And the truth shall make you free. Repair of the breach. What does he say? The restore of the paths to dwell in. the righteous paths, the righteousness of God. Let me give you a few of those paths. Righteousness, peace, and joy. The fruit of the Spirit. Long-suffering, meekness, temperance, joy. All these are pathways to righteousness. To being in right standing with the Father. Because that's what was in the Son when he was down here on this earth. And that's what's sitting there beside the Father in the kingdom of in heaven. He is sitting there at the right hand of God. And that's all he wants us to do, is to be restorers of the breach. Hello, sir. Hello, ma'am. Hello, sir. Hello, all y'all out there that's listening. We have a job. It ain't to do your own thing, but do what thus says the Lord. Just as Isaiah, he didn't do his own thing. He got hated by a lot of people, but he was doing what thus says the Lord. Help me, help me, help me now. Glory to God. I got to move on now. Read, my sister.
Verse 13. If you turn away your foot from the Sabbath,
yeah,
from doing your own pleasure, from doing your pleasure on my holy day,
yes,
and call the Sabbath a delight, the holy of the Lord, honorable, and shall honor him, not doing your own ways, nor finding your own pleasure, nor speaking your own words.
Hello, hello. Now this is deep. Because I keep trying to explain to people. Christ is the Lord of the Sabbath. So if you're going to keep anything in your heart to honor the Sabbath, it's Christ.
Yes.
You're going to be obedient every day of the week to his word. Yes. And therefore, you are keeping the Sabbath because you are keeping God's word in you every day. It ain't no one special day. It ain't Saturday. It ain't Sunday. It's Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday. It's every day of the week, every day of the month. You got to honor the Sabbath day. But we want to proclaim one certain day. Let me share with you, baby. Get in line with the word of God. If Christ is the Lord of the Sabbath, you're honoring the Sabbath every day because you're honoring the Lord of the Sabbath, the Lord of Lords and the King of Kings. You're honoring him. Therefore, you're honoring the Sabbath. I got to read this because he's speaking here. He says, if thou turn away thy foot from the Sabbath, if you turn away your foot from the Sabbath, from doing your own pleasure on my holy day, we do that, don't we? We have one day we want to sacrifice and serve him. And then the rest of the week, we go about doing what we want to do and saying what we want to say. I got someone I love so dearly in my family. He, quote unquote, supposed to be a man of God. But when he get mad, there's no righteousness coming out of his mouth. And then we were, I'm not just talking about him, I'm talking about a whole bunch of y'all out there. And then we'll holler, the Lord ain't finished with me yet. You ain't giving him a chance to get through with you yet. You want to cuss when you get mad? You even call your wife a female dog. Bitch, you better leave me alone. She ain't no dog. She's your good thing. I don't care how mad or upset she make you get. That's your good thing. You found her. She didn't find you. The Bible said he who finds a wife finds a good thing and obtaineth favor from God. You be cutting your favor off, downing your wife, saying negative things about that woman. You shouldn't even call your children, your female children, no bitches. See, I know what a bitch is. It's a dog. I got a bitch in my house and she pregnant. And when I say it, my children laugh, but I'm telling them, baby, I'm not cursing. I'm calling her what she is. That's what she's called. So if you call, if they say it about the dog, I have nothing to say. Because they're only speaking the truth. But if they are saying that, listen to what I'm saying to you. Trying to use it in a derogatory way, then they're out of order. And I have to check them. I have to chastise them. I have to correct them with the rod of correction if they can't take it up here when I'm speaking to them. Hello, somebody. See, God has called for you to be a holy nation, a royal priesthood, a chosen generation, a peculiar people, called to show forth the praises of your God. New Testament. Moving on. Got to throw it at you now. He says, and call the Sabbath a delight. Oh, this is the day we delight ourselves in the Lord. On Saturday, we keep the Sabbath day to delight ourselves in the Lord. Well, listen what he said. And call it the Sabbath of delight. The holy of the Lord, Yahweh. Listen to what he said. Honorable, and shall honor him, not doing your own ways. Not finding your own pleasure, nor speaking your own words. Let me tell you something, and I share this, not poking. But if you're going to keep the Sabbath, you got to keep all the Old Testament law. You can't keep.